So I don't know about you guys, but I'm kind of tired of people telling me that 3D printing is just a gimmick, that its only use is for printing toys or little fidget spinners and stuff, and try and explain to them all the time, no, that's not true. You can get useful, reliable, and strong parts from 3D printing. So I decided I'm gonna 3D print a knife from carbon fiber nylon. And in this video, we're gonna see what the 3D printed knife is capable of. But before that, I'm gonna show you guys how I made and modeled the knife in Fusion 360, the slicer settings I used on a stock Ender 3S1 Pro with no enclosure, so that you can get the same result. If you have no idea what I'm talking about with Fusion 360 and slicer settings and stuff, you might want to check out my beginner's guide to 3D printing first, link down in the description along with all the other stuff I'm using in this video. Anyway, if you're interested in learning how to do this yourself, or you just kind of want to see some Fruit Ninja action and some cardboard mayhem, stick around and let's get into it. Okay, so first off, let me tell you why I chose carbon fiber nylon. Nylon is a super tough plastic. It's used in everything from like buttons to seat belts. It's crazy. It's strong and resilient to heat, UV radiation, chemicals, and one of the most destructive forces on planet Earth. Watermelons. But nylon is notoriously hard to 3D print. It has a super high printing temperature and it shrinks in the cold. But when you add carbon fiber to the mix, it kind of balances everything out. So it makes it easier to print even without an enclosure. It warps a lot less and it's far more stable. And you know what? The carbon fiber makes the nylon more rigid and strong. But enough about that. Let's take a quick dive into Fusion 360. Let's go. So once I'm in Fusion 360, I open a new sketch on the top plane. The first thing I want to do is give myself guidelines so I can size the knife and get the right proportions. So I'm going to lay down two lines, one for the blade and one for the handle. First, I'm going to use the sketch dimension tool to give the line the blade will be modeled around a length of 150 millimeters, about 6 inches, and the handle a length of 100 millimeters, or about 4 inches. Now that we have the guide, we can sketch out the shape of the knife using a mix of the spline and line tools. I decided to go with a chisel design, partially inspired by a Japanese samurai sword and partially inspired by an Emerson knife I used to have. For those of you that don't know, Emerson is an American knife company that makes awesome knives. But I digress. At this point, once the outline of the knife is done, I'm going to extrude it 7 millimeters, or a little over 1/4 inch in freedom units. You see there's a little face right over there at the bottom of the knife blade. I'm gonna use this face to draw a new sketch. I'm gonna draw a line at the angle I want the bevel of the blade to be, in this case, 30 degrees, and close a profile around the part I want to cut out. At this point, I'm going to choose the top surface of the knife. And here I'm going to select the blade's outer profile line and offset the edge 1 millimeter. Once that's done, I'm going to sweep cut the bevel of the knife like a train on a rail. I'm going to choose sweep tool. And once I have that tool open, I can choose the sketch profile I made at the bottom of the blade and the rail we made using the edge of the knife and run the profile along the rail and boop, cut out the bevel of the knife edge. At this point, I'm going to give the handle some attention by giving it a few fillets, so it's more comfortable to hold, and a little guard. And with that, we can save the file. Once saved, we can export it as an STL. Okay, so by the way, if you guys have no patience for like 3D modeling and stuff, I left a link for the STL file down in the description so you can pick it up and just print it out at home without having to do all that Fusion 360 stuff. So now that we're done with that super short Fusion 360 tutorial, we're gonna jump into Cura and I'm gonna show you the settings that I used to get carbon fiber nylon printing on my stock Ender 3S1 Pro with no enclosure. I know it's not ideal, but it definitely works. So let's jump into Cura. Let's go. So the first thing you should probably do is download a carbon fiber nylon material profile for Cura. But for the sake of this video, I'm just gonna change a few settings on a pre-existing profile I have. Okay, So first, I'm gonna go into the settings for the print, and I'm gonna double the walls from 4 to 8, and do the same for the top and bottom layers. Then I'm gonna ramp up the infill to 50%. Once that's done, I'm gonna move on to the important stuff, the print settings. Nylon likes it hot, so I'm gonna set my hot end at 280 degrees and my build plate to 110. And for printing CF nylon, we gotta turn the cooling fan off. So nylon prints at a super high temperature, and it likes to shrink and warp while it's cooling. So the build plate and the fan settings are crucial if you don't want your print to warp, detach from the build plate, and spaghettisize on you. Once we got all that tuned in, we can pop the knife into Cura and send her on her way. So we got our knife all set to print. At this point, you're probably gonna wanna know that carbon fiber nylon is one of the thirstiest filaments out there. This stuff likes to suck moisture out of the air like a student loan sucks the money out of your bank account. You gotta make sure to dry this stuff real good before you hook it up to your printer. If you don't have a filament dryer, you can easily use your oven if your family doesn't murder you. I would suggest drying the filament at 60 degrees or 140 degrees Fahrenheit for at least an hour or two or three. Once your filament is dry as a bone, you can hook it up to your printer. By the way, at this point, it's best to have your carbon fiber nylon fed directly to your printer from a filament dryer. If you don't have a filament dryer, you're gonna be fine. The print just might not look as pretty. That's about it. Okay, so once I finish printing the knife and cleaning it up, it's time to see what it can do. But before that, if you guys are enjoying this and you wanna see more goofy tutorials and product reviews, maybe you'd consider subscribing and stabbing that like button so I can keep improving and sending out better content. So let's see what this guy can do.
Next time somebody tells you 3D printing is just a gimmick, show them this video.